This is a $2,500 electric unicycle. Max speed of 37 miles per hour, rated range up to 96 miles on a full charge, 2,800 watt motor built in, we got touchscreen, Bluetooth speaker, tons of fancy features. This is the InMotion V12 HT, or high torque. I'm Ben Schmanke from AuthenTech, and let's check it out.
Let's get it unboxed and set it up. This thing looks like a monster. Oh man, that's so heavy. All right, here we go. Two hands, baby. This is my workout for the week. Oh yeah. Holy smokies. Kickstand, yes. All right, it looks so cool, but right before we get to it, let me see what else is included. You got your user manual here. Charging brick, this thing is a monster. Matches the size of the EUC. Output, 100 volt, 2.3 amp, 231 watts. Now they also sent me their honeycomb pedals and power pads. We'll get that set up in a minute. All right, first impressions, the thing is monstrous. You can just see me standing next to it. It comes up to my mid thigh. Stand it up. Ouch. Oh, this wheel is just ginormous. It's hard to kind of convey how big this thing looks. Yeah, so you got some padding up here and then no padding on the side. So this is where you gotta put those side pads. You'll feel it on your shins and ankles and such. It's wanting me to activate the vehicle.
Please activate your vehicle.
Love the kickstand. Unfortunately, without activating it, the whole thing doesn't even work. So just something to note. All right, I download the app, signed up or logged in.
Please activate your vehicle.
All right, let's activate the vehicle. Let's go ahead and search again. The InMotion app found the V12. Yeah, of course you need my location, that's horrible. Pedometer, remainder range, battery's at 37%. Wow, lots of stats there. Mileage, efficiency, consumption, that's kind of neat. Reminds me of like a Tesla or something. In settings, we can diagnose. Dazzling light effects. Sure, let's do colorful. Transfer it over. Lock it, low beam lights, brightness, spin kill, speed clamp, max speed, speeding, braking, sound wave. There's a lot of customization in the app, which is kind of neat. Ooh, remainder range, I like that. Let's see if there's a firmware update. Ooh, I think it says there is. Let's go ahead and update it. Update the firmware, it's even showing that on the display. That's kind of neat. All right, while that firmware is updating, let's go ahead and check out these boxes. Ooh, look at that. Ooh, look at it on there, it's showing the progress. Man, look at these like pegs for grip on here. It says enter password. All right, make sure you guys don't look. Yeah, let's go ahead and give it a couple more minutes. I don't wanna rush it. So for pedal comparison, these are the old. I mean, it's got nice grip tape on there and stuff. They're not bad at all, but okay, they're actually maybe not bigger in size, but there you go. If it looks like it's frozen, just go ahead and give it some minutes and I think it's still working. Oh, look at these, nice padding. Wow, now these things are monsters. Double-sided sticky there. That's gonna lock in your feet and give some really good comfort padding, hopefully. This reminds me of the old Android rooting days. It says warm tips updated successfully. Yes. Got it all updated. Let's do a quick little ride inside the office. This could be a bad idea. Oh, yes. All right, now let's go ahead and get charged up and go out for some test rides. Charging port, USB type A, type C. I'm gonna go for a very first slow, easy test ride and see how it goes. Just plugged in the charger. It shows that it's red on here, and then shows the charging here on the screen, which is cool. But I think it'd be nicer if it showed me a battery percentage or maybe time remaining. After my first ride, the first thing that stuck out to me was I was riding way too high and it kind of felt wobbly and insecure. Well, great news, we can actually lower it down. There's three height adjustment settings for the pedals. So it was set at the highest, which is great for off-roading and a lot of clearance and stuff. But for street cruising, I didn't like it. It wasn't very comfortable. So let's go ahead and lower that down. Ouch. Look at this. I just pinched the same finger in a new spot. What is going on? I believe you loosen this guy. Then push out the pin. The pedal's gonna come off. Oh, God. Don't lose the spacers, one on each side. Now we can see this little block that these things for release. Then we can move it up and down. So there we go. We got those three position holes. It was up at the top. It was too high for me. So middle and low. I'm gonna go down to the lowest. Nice. And of course, don't forget the set screw on the bottom.
Boom, way faster and easier the second time around. I did try accessing these without taking off the pedal, and it's just a little bit too angled. I'm sure it could be done, but once you know how fast and easy, you just get something long, pound out that pin, make sure this guy is in and out, and it's not too bad.
All right, fully charged, battery life 100%, 68 mile range.
Bright sunlight, we can still sort of see the display, which is nice. Love the handle, though the button to press it in is up here, which is a little bit awkward, but it's not bad. Nice little rubber grip handle here. And that kickstand, man, that's probably one of my favorite features on this thing.
Can you hear that? That's really loud. That's so great.
One small glitch I found with that speaker, if you have music jamming and the sound wave turned on, which is that fake motor sound when you accelerate, you can hear it cutting in and out. This thing weighs 65 pounds, so sure, you can kind of lift and move it around, but man, it is dang heavy, especially for someone kind of weak like me.
Oh!
All right, let's go riding downtown. Semi-steep hill, test number one. Not too bad, pretty. Oh shoot! Just gonna say it's pretty muddy down here. Oh snap. Alright, not too bad. Now let's move on to hill number two. Did I mention the HT is for high torque? So this is hill number two or three or whatever. Let's see if it can handle it. It's more like if I can handle it. All right. Man, I really need those grip pads to be able to pinch the wheel and then just pull it up to go at a little bit faster speeds. But yeah, of course, it can handle it easy. Now, of course, this wheel is very capable of some great off-roading power and potential. However, I will say, I am really missing the suspension from my last AUC. You really feel every little bump on this thing. All that, it doesn't feel very good. So yeah, I'm missing that suspension system for sure. For max speed, I think they rate this thing up to 37 miles per hour, 2800 watt power motor or something nutty like that. That is insane. In no way am I skilled or crazy enough to try to push my luck with those speeds. I think I'm able to cruise a little bit faster on some of my other without that issue. I think it might be due to that heavy weight. I did lower those pedals all the way down and that did help quite a bit. One feature I'm really digging is this display up here. I love being able to see my exact miles range, battery percentage. I can customize settings from in here without pulling out my phone. That's really nice. So hold on the miles per hour if you want to switch it around. You can hold on miles to kind of customize this display. That's pretty neat. I will say the touch input is a little finicky. I mean, you can just see that the display is a little bit laggy, and sometimes when I press codes or things to try to unlock it, it doesn't really register. Register all my tabs, but it's not a major deal. Either way, I appreciate this display. I like it. After riding around for a bit, I will say my ankles, I mean, they're kind of hurting. It's just bouncing against that straight plastic side, and some foam padding or something is definitely a must. The overall design is pretty nice. I like that kind of matte black all over, just these little orange accents of the InMotion, and on that wheel. The colored LEDs, they're just not as bright or as poppy as their marketing images show, but it's not bad. I mean, I like this little ring around here, and you get some on the front, some on the back. The headlights are really nice. The low high beams are all four on. Those are pretty bright, especially in the parking garages and riding at nighttime. Range feels pretty incredible. The battery inside's a massive 1750 watt hours. They rate it can go up to 96 miles on a full charge. This day when I was riding around, the battery showed 91% and 96 miles left. Now, of course, they'll fluctuate with battery drain and speed and such, but the takeaway for me, I could go riding for hours and hours and still have plenty of juice left to go out riding the next day or multiple days. For me, I usually just bring it home, recharge it, and then I'm set. No range anxiety with this one.
The walking handle is definitely another one of my favorite features. It's really nice to have. Bam, pop it up. You can walk it down some steps maybe if you're next to the water and you don't want to go falling in. I don't trust myself. Then you got steps like this. Instead of your wheel spinning out, you just press this little middle button, disengages the motor. Boom. Oh, lift the sucker up, break your back because it's super heavy, and go cruising again. A little bit of a workout riding and carrying this thing around.
Let's quick talking about just the riding experience of an electric unicycle. Once you get over that steep learning curve, the feeling is just kind of incredible. It's like you're floating through the air. That Segway-like self-balancing is just so fun. Gliding anywhere from sidewalks, streets, can jump off curbs, ride up hills and off-road terrain. It's like the ultimate exploring machine.
And another reason I just love riding electric unicycles is just your hands are free. Check this out. I'm able to talk to a camera or text, do Google Maps. I mean, I don't know if I recommend that, but yeah, just having your hands free while sort of safely gliding your way around. It's super fun. It's an exhilarating feeling. All right, I was out cruising for a long while. It's still at 90%. It says available mileage 94 miles. Not sure if that's right, but either way, I got plenty left on this thing. That's crazy.
There's insane power under the hood. I definitely wouldn't recommend this one for the beginners. It's good for maybe the intermediate or the pros. That range is crazy. The max speed and the torque is just insane. I'm nowhere near capping those out. My two biggest wishlist items is A, that weight at 65 pounds is just so heavy to carry around and to ride around. I definitely think I strained some back muscles that day I was riding all around. Just all that weight trying to maneuver. I was working muscles I didn't even know I had, so I need to get back into the gym. And secondly, I'm really missing that suspension system like I had on my Kingsong S18. You feel every bump on this heavy beast. I'll give you the link to check out more info down in the description. Also future updates in a pinned comment. Check out my other electric scooter videos here, and I'll see you subscribers in the next video.